How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a very warm welcome to my very first model train review to come of September 2024. And just like I mentioned in last week's review, this is the second Bachmann model that I have. And this one, folks, is a 00 gauge Bachmann Class 20-3 in the Harry Needle Railroad Corporation. And details are as follows. And I'll tell you something, I really like this colourful bright orange livery on this Class 20. Do you not think that looks cool? But we will come more to that when we unbox it. And here we go, folks. This one is, the reference number is 35-126A. Class 20-3, numbered as 20314. So 20314. In the Harry Needle Railroad Company livery. So I was almost correct. I just said corporation, but no bother. And by the way, folks, this has the Plux 22 DCC. I'm on maximum zoom, so I'm going to have to move the turntable back a wee bit, because even though this box is relatively shorter than the, let's say, the Class 47 that I did at the end of last month, and I thought that'd be a nice one to end August with, this one, wee bit shorter, but it's still quite chunky and big. But Bachmann, I kind of compare them as the model train version of Mercedes Benz when it comes to their mechanisms and that. And I'm sure you will agree with me that their drivelines and the quality is just, you know, it's onto its own class, really, you know. Anyways, got the blister packaging. And before we move on to the Class 20 itself, here are the details. So we've got the Collectors Club pamphlet and stuff there, so that's an interesting club to join if you want to get access to the limited edition exclusive model trains and stuff if you are a Bachmann collector. So that's worth a look. And here we go, manual, locomotive information and all that good stuff. Got a Bachmann decoder, which is the Plux 22. It does have speakers if you want to add sound, which is the 8-ohm type, just for those that may not be aware. And fitment of the detail parts and stuff. Anyways, moving on. This is body shell removal, running in, adding accessories and that. And check out this cool feature, folks. Underneath the air tank, which I will show you when we cover underneath the model when we unbox it, you have four switches, folks. Which is numbered 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we've got the nose end directional lights, cab end directional lighting, cab lights and directional lights for day and off for night. That's number 4. So yes, folks, you can use day and night mode on this, and the lights on this are absolutely gorgeous. You will see that in the performance test, but as you know, I like to be very thorough on these model train reviews and just make sure we're delivering all the quality and all that. I like to be thorough. So, there we go. That's the manuals all done. So, without further ado, let's get this beautiful model out of the box then. Okay, that case just slides off like so. And before we go any further, just to show you the detail bag with all the parts and everything, brake hoses, plows, a spare coupler which just clips on if you wish to put the coupling on both ends, of which is the cab end this time around. And that's all there really is. So just let me roll my sleeves up, folks, because I don't want to knock the camera flying with the sleeves. Let's get this out the box then. So what do we have here then, folks? We have a very gorgeous looking Class 20. And yes, it does. Sprung buffers. Just look at that beautiful detail on the roof there, folks. We've got this giant fan, of which, by the way, is non-spinning on this version. I'm not sure if there's a deluxe version of this Class 20 or not. I have no idea, but it does have fully working lights. And this is the first time I've ever reviewed a Bachmann Class 20, and overall I find this a very nice model, and it is a solid puller. So due to the fact that these models have an abundance of detailed parts. I just have to be very careful how I handle this so I don't break anything. But just check that out, folks. We've got no traction tires at all. This is pure raw organic part. It's not like it's been put in a pool of lubricant, and I do like that. So thank you, Bachmann, for improving your quality over older models that I've had. So thank you for that. And we do have, this is where the switches are, underneath these air tanks, and these just simply unclip to grant you access to those. And you just need something like a small screwdriver or a cocktail stick to flick the switches on and off, and away you go. And we've got the NEM coupler on this end, of which is the nose end or the hood end, and I'm just trying to turn this around for you without damaging anything. And that, my friends, is the unboxing and introduction of the Bachmann Class 20 all done. And I really am looking forward to doing the close-ups, the rotation, and the fun part, of which will be the performance test. Okay, folks, it's now time to move on to the close-ups. And just for the benefit of this video, I'm just going to do one of these as a thumbnail until I decide which one to pick, as I try to get them with the lights running if I can. And the lighting on this one is absolutely beautiful. And I've just got an itchy right hand, so that's a good luck symbol. So I'm just going to itch that on the wood, and may it come good. Or it could be an old tale, who knows? Only the universe. But anyways, joking aside, let's get on with it then, folks. And let's home in on the front cab. So folks, what have we got here then? Starting from the rooftop, we do have the NRN radio pod and the GSMR receiver on the roof. We also have another electronic beacon receiver, of which is just the top of the cab here. And we've got the horn mesh molded into the model, so that's grand. We do have separately fitted wipers. And the detail on this one is absolutely fantastic. And this is a Class 20-3, so it does have the squared off cab windows as per the real things. And it doesn't have the curved windows on the cab sides. But we do have full flush glazing all round. So again, thank you, Bachmann, for doing this for us. It really is appreciated. We do have what you'd call the Whipac or Y-Pack headlights, of which is the marker lights and the headlights, and these can be turned on and off via the switches underneath. We do have sprung buffers, of which I showed you in the introduction, and I may add the buffer beam detail or the pilot detail in later, I don't know. But just look at this, folks, absolutely beautiful HN rail, which is the Harry Needle Railroad Company. Although I did say corporation at the start, but no bother. Just check these trucks out, folks. We've got the footsteps. We've got an abundance of separately fitted and detailed parts. We've got the printed brake discs. We've got the legible decos and stuff. And we've got the legible detailing on the battery boxes on the sides of the locomotive. So that's all grand. We've got the piping picked out nicely in an off-white colour. So well done, Bachmann. And okay, one could argue that these models are not cheap when they are first released, but you get what you pay for. And a lot of detail and planning does go into these Bachmann models. So we have the large grille, and coming up to the roof, the large grille, which is for the radiators, is just beneath the fan. And we've got metal handrails on the sides too. And we've got other ventilation grills picked out in black. Very nice touch to this model. We've also got the overhead catenary warning stripe across the top, as well as various danger signs and stuff in that too. So we've also got the MU cable, which I did forget to mention when we were at this end. So That's all the details and everything all covered. So, that's the close-ups all done. So it's now time for us to move over to the full rotation before we go for the serious fun stuff. And that, my friends, is the performance test. Rightio, folks. It's now time to commence on with the full rotation. And without further ado, let's zoom on out. And as you can see here, folks, I've used a shorter section of track just to accommodate this Class 20. So I shouldn't need to adjust the camera too much this time around, as this locomotive is relatively shorter and it is more forgiving in terms of the camera angles and stuff. But the detail is very much self-explanatory. And yes, folks, the headlights and the tail lights do work on the back as well as the front. So again, well done to Bachmann for putting in so much effort into this 00 gauge UK model train of the Class 20-3, of which is an English electric diesel locomotive. So there we go, folks. That's the full rotation all done. So that's all the coverage and everything done in terms of the close-ups and the rotation. So without further ado, let's get this one down on the test track and let's see how it handles under the performance test. Okay, folks, without further ado, it's now time to commence on with the performance test. And I'll tell you something, I'm sure you will agree with me that when the lights come on this locomotive, you're going to absolutely love it. So, without further ado, let's zoom on out, nice and far back. And I've just put it just parallel to the railroad crossing. So, we are using my analog controller. This is 25% power, folks. That's only a quarter of the way. And this Bachmann Class 20 is just taking off at a nice, comfortable speed. And as you can see, it is preset to daytime mode, as we've got the marker light on the bottom and the headlight in the middle in between the two cab windows or such like. And just increase that power to about, there we go, nice 40% power. As you can see there, 40% power, no slipping. And this is a much smaller locomotive than the others I've covered, so this is kind of an extreme load test on this Bachmann Class 20 with these 8 tank cars. And to be quite frankly honest, I do like to put my model trains through their paces and stuff, because as you know, folks, I'm not sponsored or supported or financed by any model train company. I pay for all these model trains myself, and in truth, I just like to give something back to the model train community in terms of unofficial but truthful, honest reviews. But just look at that performance there, folks. That's only on 40% power. In fact, I think it's about 35% power. So let's take that up to about 4.5, let's say 4 volts. Actually, scratch that, let's take it up 40% power, 5 volts. And if we take it up to exactly 50% power, this is exactly 6 volts. And this locomotive just goes. It is geared for a higher top speed, as I'm assuming that the Class 20 diesel locomotives, when they were built, they are geared to do 80 miles an hour, and that's the Class 20s. But if I do have those details wrong, please do leave a comment and let me know with the correct data below, and feel free to correct me accordingly, as at the end of the day, I'm not perfect. I'm prone to making mistakes just like everybody else is, and it helps me to learn more about locomotives that I'm not really too familiar with. even though I did see the Class 20s quite a lot during the 1980s when I was growing up as a child in the 1980s. You don't see too many of them about nowadays around the UK mainland like you would have done in the mid-1980s. But I do like these classic locomotives, and I do like this orange colour. The orange and black livery, it really does look nice. Although, I've not really heard of this railway operator much, to be honest, as I never really saw them about much, but I do remember seeing these Class 20s with some of the London Underground S-Stock that was around 2010, 2011, when these Class 20s were delivering them to, from Derby to London, when they were being delivered to the London Underground, and that was to replace the District Line, the Metropolitan Line, and the Circle Line tube stock with those trains. But in all honesty, I don't really know too much about the Class 20s, but other than they do make a nice turbo whistly sound when they're idling, they do sound nice when they're idling, if you've heard the real things, or at least they do, in my opinion. And it's also nice for me to cover more of the Bachmann model trains this year of 2024 onto the channel. So I wanted to kickstart this month of September off with a Bachmann Class 20. Will I cover a Class 37? Who knows? You'll have to wait and see. But I do have a very nice model train coming up that will either be next week or it will be the week after. But you'll have to stay tuned for that one, folks. I don't want to ruin any surprises, and I'm not being mean. I just like to keep content as a guest, just to keep everyone excited. But all I'm going to say is there will be one model train this month, at least one this month, that will be a European HO style model train that I do plan to cover on this channel. And yes, folks, I will use these tank cars with it just as a load test, but it is what it is. I run what I want. It's my model railway, and that's the rules. So strictly rule one applies here. Just run what you want, enjoy yourself, and that's what the hobby is all about. Just look at that, folks. It's just cruising along like it's got all day. And there is a nice amount of weight to this Bachmann Class 20. It's not too heavy. It's lighter than the other model trains that I've covered recently. It's one of the lighter ones, but it's just pulling these tank cars with no resistance at all. And this is a lightweight diesel locomotive. And by the way, folks, I do plan to do a new review of a Cavalex Models Class 56, as I'm just waiting for them to do a second run of their Class 56 models, albeit with a different number, and I may do a Colas version this time around. If not, it will be another DC Rail one, as I like to cover the modern day stuff. So I like to be fair, and I'm willing to give model train companies another chance, as I like to be fair to everyone. But I do have this principle of three strikes and they're out. So I just like to be fair and neutral with all companies and stuff and that, you know. But I'll tell you something, I'm so glad that I've managed to get this Class 20 review done this year, as I do like Bachmann, and I'm looking forward at doing a review of one of their Class 31s in the future as well, that was announced in their range this year. So I will be looking forward to doing my own review of that one, and that will likely be when I do have a full-fledged model railway and stuff, you know. So I've just got to check to see how long I've been filming here, and we've been filming here for about, I'm just going to tap that again, it just went off. So I've been filming here for about, let's say 9 minutes. So let's calculate that to about 2 to 3 more passes, and we can then switch the camera, and then I can show you just how bright the tail lights are. And I'll tell you something, folks, I've had a super awesome day today. I'm in such a good mood, I feel happy, and I just love creating this content, and I really do love the way my life is going, you know. It's no secret, the only thing I've practiced is just gratitude and appreciation, and I express my gratitude and appreciation to the universe for being able to do these unofficial but honest model train reviews from a neutral perspective. Okay folks, one more and then we will switch the camera. I really am super excited here. Okay folks, this is just an observation of the tail lights on this Bachmann Class 20 diesel locomotive. That is the Bachmann Class 20-3 in the HNRC livery, or the Harry Needle Railroad Company livery, of which I will admit it is very stylish. And they've got cab lights on this model that do work on analog. It's just sadly, on the Class 47 review that I did at the end of last month, the cab lights on the newer Class 47 are just a DCC only feature, as well as Class 20. You can turn them on and off with a switch on the bottom, so it's nice to have that flexibility. And in terms of my model railway, I do plan to go digital, but I will likely start off with just analog, with the Caddo Unitrack and the Caddo train controllers and all that good stuff. But I will likely go digital in the future when I do build my full-fledged model railway, as when I do build that one, it will be a big project. That's all I'm going to say on that, folks. But just look at that. Cruising along absolutely effortlessly. Just cruising along very nicely. And we're 2 minutes into this part of the video, so we're almost halfway through this section before we start wrapping up this Class 20 review. And I've got to say, folks, I really have enjoyed this one, and I've had such a beautiful day today. I could not ask for a better day. That's all I'm going to say, folks. I could not ask for a better day. But then again, this is what happens when you live by gratitude an appreciation for what you've got and not what you don't have. And that's just me. Absolutely amazing. So, here is the question. Would I recommend getting the Bachmann Class 20? The answer is, that's up to you. It's down to your personal tastes and preference. My role in doing these unofficial reviews, of which I have been doing on and off since 2010, is to help the community make informed decisions based on the information of what these reviews that I post on my channel will deliver to you. And it's really up to you to make your own judgments and your own decisions. If you really want one of these, get one. If you're starting off in model trains and you've only got a small model railway, this Class 20 is definitely worth considering, and it is a shorter locomotive too, so although it is recommended to run it on second radius curve track, of which is now the normal for this one, I can't say it would work on first radius curve track without issues, as there is a lot of detailed parts on these model trains and they could get easily damaged if used on tighter track curves and stuff. Just like with all the reviews I've done this year of 2024 in 00 gauge and HO style, this color track is about 5th and 6th radius curve track, so that's just a guide there, folks. But anyways, it's now time to start winding down this video. Right, folks. Without further ado, let's start winding this one down into the four categories. Details and features. Working cab lights. Superb interior detailing. I have decided not to do the coverage of the cab this time around, as I'm experimenting with different views between different reviews and stuff, but as I always say in all of my reviews, do let me know your thoughts on by giving me feedback on my reviews and stuff, as it does help folks. So details and features, we've got working cab lights, detailed cab interior, exceptional detailing inside and out on this model train. We've got day and night mode on the headlights. Separately fitted etched roof fan under the grille, amongst other things. 5 out of 5, folks. Well deserved 5 out of 5 on details and features. Performance. Just like with the Class 47, this Class 20 also comes with a coreless motor, an all-wheel drive mechanism, and there's a nice amount of weight to the chassis. It's not as heavy as the larger locomotives, but there's enough weight to this locomotive and it's geared to haul this test train with no issues, and there is no wheel slip, and the slight incline on this room floor is a natural incline and decline in terms of testing the torque of the motor and the mechanism, and it handles it really well. So I'm going to give performance a full house 5 out of 5. Quality, nothing damaged, nothing missing. It's a complete model that's been beautifully crafted and well made. 5 out of 5. Price, this one The price of these can range between anything from £130 to about £150. So shop about. It is a wee bit expensive for what it is. So I'm going to give the price for this Bachmann Class 20 a 4 out of 5. So that rounds us off with an acceptable 9 out of 10 for this Bachmann Class 20-3. And folks, I just want to say to you, if you're still here watching the video, big thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other. All the best, God bless, take care, and I will see you in the next one. I'll do one more pass, and then we will wrap up this video then, folks, okay?